Microsoft finally gave us some more details on the Surface Duo, their long-awaited dual-screen Android Surface device. And here's the surprising thing, you can order it right now, today, for $13.99. It's going to be shipping to customers on September 10th, which sounds like it's in the range of where the iPhone event typically lands. So that's very exciting to have this thing coming so early. That price is also really interesting because it comes in a lot less than the Galaxy Fold did. That was over $2,000. And we don't know what the Galaxy Z Fold 2 is going to be priced at, but probably going to be around that. Now, Samsung did price the Galaxy Z Flip at around $1,380. So that's kind of the range Microsoft is going for here. It's clearly premium, but also not exorbitant. You know, people are paying nearly that amount for iPhones these days too, and other high-end Android phones. During a brief demo with press, Microsoft just showed off where they were with the Surface Duo software. And honestly, it looks a lot more polished than what we saw last October. And it's the same basic deal. It is two separate screens that you can use as a single large screen or use it for multitasking too. And from what we've seen, you can create things like app groups, basically two apps that when you hit a button in the launcher, two apps launch side by side. So it could be Google Maps and Spotify, it could be, you know, Outlook and Microsoft Teams or something, whatever you want. And Microsoft showed off a couple other interesting features too. You know, some apps can be optimized for this dual screen. So back in October, we saw the Kindle app do it, and they showed us that too. Amazon actually did a little work to get some nice page turning and, you know, that sort of look and UI into that app. But even without any changes, there's some really interesting interactions between Android apps too. If you open a map, for example, if you hit a navigation link on Google Maps and the other screen that you're looking at is empty, it'll automatically load up those directions over there. It seems like overall, Microsoft has thought a lot about balancing how you're actually using your device. So if you have an empty screen, you know, external links from your text messages or external links from your email will pop up there too. So it doesn't interrupt your flow of actually going through your mail or something. That's really what Microsoft is going through here. Microsoft gave us some tech details that give us a better sense of how the Surface Duo will perform. It's powered by a Snapdragon 855 processor, so not the latest and greatest, but still a pretty fast mobile CPU. It also just has a single camera. It's an 11 megapixel shooter, and that's the thing that kind of shows up right above the display. To use it as a rear camera, you'd have to fold the screen around and use it in phone mode. And you know, it's a weird solution because they didn't want to put a camera on the rear of the device because it had to be foldable, right? And I'm not quite sure how it's going to stack up to the highest end Android cameras that you can get today. Microsoft says there is an HDR feature on the camera and a portrait mode and some zoom capabilities, but it is just a single camera. So it's not gonna have the great depth of field flexibility that a dual or even triple camera will have. I really don't know how it's gonna hold up compared to everything else. What we do know is that the company really isn't pushing this as a camera heavy device. It seems like it's gonna be basically a serviceable shooter. The Surface Duo is gonna have a 3500 milliamp dual battery. It's kind of spanned across both displays. And from the specs we've seen, it seems like one side is bigger than the other. Not quite sure how that's gonna work out in real life. Right now, Microsoft is saying you can expect all day battery life. That can mean a lot of different things. They're saying 15 and a half hours of local video playback and about 10 days of standby time. The Surface Duo is also going to be launching with 128 gigabytes of storage for that $13.99 price. There's also a 256 gigabyte model that's going to be a little more. We don't quite know the exact price for that yet. Honestly, I'm surprised. I think Microsoft would want to put up to 512 in a device like this, or at least give us expandable storage. You know, as an overall device, this is sort of the courier type of thing I've been waiting for from Microsoft. You know, a booklet style device that could fit in my pocket that I can open up and use as a tablet as I need to. Microsoft mentioned that some executives are up and around with this device already. Microsoft CEO Satya Nadella is using it. We saw a tweet from Hiroshi Lockheimer, the head of Android over at Google, is also, you know, showing off his. This seems like something, you know, people are actually using in daily life, and it seems like it's going pretty well for them. It does seem like it could be a device that works a little more like a computer, maybe taking over that tablet role for some people. For me, it's going to be interesting to see how this leads to the Surface Neo, which is a dual screen Windows device. And I think Microsoft has had a lot more trouble making smaller Windows devices and certainly Windows tablets work because the apps aren't there. That's kind of Panos's main reason for saying why they went with Android. It's all about the apps, and that makes a lot of sense too. They shined a little more light too about why this is a dual screen device rather than a folding device. And the basic idea is that you can multitask more easily across two screens. And you can also fold this flat. You can fold it all the way around. It's a 360 degree hinge. And you can't really do that with folding phones. They're a lot more delicate. There's always a gap between the screen. Last October, I wrote that, you know, this strategy just seems like a much more durable way to get into dual screens. And I still think that's the case based on what we've seen so far. We're hoping to get our hands on the Surface Duo soon. Stay tuned to Engadget.com for more news about dual screen devices. And if you dug this video, be sure to like and subscribe.